I'm going to tell you about my experience in LARPing with politicians and state officials. And yeah, like the first question I would like to ask is like, why even do that? But I think for us, people who believe in the power of LARP, it's kind of a nice idea, right? Wouldn't it be nice to just like gather all the politicians in one room and like drop a bomb on them? No, to run a LARP for them, yeah, and make them realize how like maybe unfair and mean some of their actions are, and how they can struggle with us to make the world a better place, right? Through the power of LARP. But for some reason, this is kind of a rare opportunity, and that doesn't present itself really often. So, like, what we do in our work is that we look for these kind of, we call them windows of opportunity, and then we launch ourselves into them. And I'm going to tell you about like how our recent experience with that. And first, I'm going to give you some background on the story, like how we started working with them. And then I'm going to tell you about some of the experiences that we had with those people and how they LARP. So the story behind that is that now there is like a new government program for modernization of Russian economy, which is called data economy. And we've already had a bunch of those, and none of them were really successful. But this is a new one, and of course it won't fail. The idea is that nowadays, like all government work, it generates an awful lot of data, right? But it is assembled in a way that you can't really do anything with it afterwards, because a lot of it is still like somewhere buried deep in papers, and no one really knows how to use it to implement, to affect our decisions. But at the same time, it kind of becomes more and more important, like because we want politicians to take decisions that use like real knowledge about what's going on. So people even say that data is the new oil, and us Russians, we care a lot about oil. So data becomes more and more important in solving public problems. And so the volume of the data available is it's growing faster than the ability of government to do something with it. So this new program is created to help people analyze and make sense of the data and then implement it in government decision-making processes. And so the idea is that some new wonderful state official has to like appear, and they are like chief data officers, some new magical people that are going to manage this transition to the new data-driven culture. And like they are supposed to be people who understand very well how IT works and how we can assemble data and then use it. But at the same time, Russia has maybe 1 million and 200 of state officials, so you can't really fire all of them and like hire some new wonderful modern day officials. You have to teach those like old dogs new tricks. It's still the same people that have been doing all the like traditional paperwork, and now they don't only have to learn how to do an awful lot of stuff in IT, but they also have to, you know, get on board with the general idea, because they don't really understand what this new data economy is and how it is supposed to work. And people don't really trust that this modernization is even possible, because we've had so many other programs that failed. And also the transparency that comes with the new IT systems doesn't really benefit the established order, because do you really like want to for everything to be transparent if you can maybe like double the budget of your educational organization using like the false names and the lists? So you like care for this opportunity, so you maybe don't want too much light to be like shed upon it. So that's this question: how do we teach people these new things if they are not really like on board? And then we use LARP as one of the techniques to do that, because first it is kind of fancy, you know, LARPing, it's really new, so like people want to use it, but also it helps us to make better teams of these people. And we want them to be on board with us. So we want them to have this right mindset when they can implement the change. And we want them to have more empathy for the people that they're working for, because like sometimes the state officials, they're really like separated from the people they're working for. And also, after we have taught them some things, we want to test what they've learned in some kind of safe environment, not really put them directly to real people. And now I'm going just to tell you about our experience with, like, about running LARPs with officials, because it seems that some of the things they're doing differently, not like just any one of us LARPing. And maybe like our experience so far, we are running a program for some 200 people, like state officials that are being taught all those new IT things, and we also LARP with them to like get them on board with the whole idea. And we've also run a couple of LARPs at the Eastern Economic Forum, which is a big Russian event for 6,000 people, including like 10 presidents and prime ministers of different countries. Well, they didn't LARP with us yet, but we hope for the best. So maybe some of the things that I'm going to tell you are also like relevant for just non-LARPers LARPing, but well, those guys really take it up to the top. So, how do they do it, and how do you design for it? First thing about politicians LARPing is that they don't want to give up their real-life power at all. Like, of course, a lot of us don't, maybe, like, but for them, it's really in their blood. So they really have this vertical structure, which is very rigid. So when you share them in groups, you can really soon find out that it's not the appointed leader taking all the decisions, but more his like real life boss. So maybe if you're splitting them in groups, it's worth to put all the vice governors into one group and all the press secretaries into the other to like kind of disrupt these real life hierarchies. The other thing is that they love papers. Like out of yeah, like normally we think that workshops are much better than the written instructions, but not for those people. Like they, because if they have the instruction, if they understand it, like they're perfect with that. And they really suffer when we workshop with them. They're like, why are you even making us do it? We have the manual. Why? So yeah, like with them, it's worth to like investing more of your time into doing the instruction and not into like this practice, because yeah. Another thing is that they are really competitive. Whenever there's a victory at hand, they like it's oof. They like fight to death, and at the same time, especially when it's like some program that's specially organized for politicians, for like officials, they feel evaluated all the time. Like at all, they feel like they're being watched. Like every action of them is judged, and so they're trying to win. So our advice is maybe to go as Nordic as you can and design collaboratively. Like there shouldn't be really like the prize, because otherwise, like they won't get focused on anything but that. Because it's really, really important for them. And another thing that we have seen is that, well, they're serious people, so they don't really want to do, you know, like the fantasy stuff. Like they wanted to have some serious appearance, because, like as we've learned from Hilda, like switching between the layers, like it can be really tough, especially for non-LARPers. So you want to take it somewhere close to home, but at the same time, you can't really use the real life material, because that would immediately lead them to really dig into the tiniest details. Like you want to teach them how they can like transform their real life actions, but at the same time, it can't be like too close to home. Choose some like realistic, but not like, well, in our case, Russian like environment for the LARP. So these are like the main things that we have seen. And thank you very much for your attention.